in. Ask him to rise. Stacy, ask him to rise.
Wait for the music.
Wait till the music is gone.
Will you please rise? Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for allowing us to be together on this special day in our lives, for letting us share the happiness we feel with our friends, family, and fellow graduates. Please watch over and bless each of us as we go our separate ways and prepare for our new beginnings in life. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.
I'd like to ask Miriam Woodrow and Bill Howard to come forward, please. Why don't you come up here? We have three professional educators retiring from the Southeast Fountain School Corporation this year. Jack Hart from the high school cannot be with us today. Mrs. Woodrow has spent 30 years serving public education. She has taught kindergarten for 22 years and has worked 18 years in the Southeast Fountain School Corporation. Mr. Howard has spent 31 years serving public education. He started teaching in Hillsboro, went to Richland Township, and has been a principal in our school corporation for 20 years. I'd like for you to join with us as we express our deepest appreciation for their dedicated service to public education and to the Southeast Fountain School Corporation, and our sincere wishes for many years of health and happiness.
I'm proud this day to have the honor of introducing our salutatorian, Gray Lawson. Gray is the son of Mr. and Mrs. Herb Lawson of Route 1 Attica. He has been active in band, swim team, was National Honor Society president, and our senior class president. Gray?
Mr. York, Mr. Williams, Mr. Kronk, members of the school board, faculty, family, friends, and my fellow graduates. Recently, a few of my classmates and I received a graduation card from a very special lady, one whose company includes Santa Claus, our first pet, and our first sweetheart as our favorite childhood memories. Inside the card was a folded piece of yellowed paper with a long string of gaudy 2-inch letters on it that were so placed that there were no breaks between the words. You see, this card was from my first grade teacher, Mrs. Betty Jo Sowers. She explained that the letter inside was one of my own hand, an essay from first grade on what I remembered most about that year. Mine referred to the infamous Dick, Jane, and Spot, and it read, "I remember when I got my level one book, and two, and three, and four, and five. I learned how to read." For others, the memories were different, but for all, the message was the same. The year was 1974, first grade was over, and we were on our way, racing fiercely and without hesitation to this day, a day that we could look back and say, we've done it. And now that the finish line is just within our grasp, let us reflect for a moment on the race that we have run. First, notice that there are no previous record holders, for we, the class of 1984, are the very first to attend K through 12 at the Southeast Fountain School Corporation. For most of us, these 80 acres are all that we know in the way of formal education. The corporation has been one to nurture our curiosities, build our foundations, and expand our horizons. Our curiosities needed satisfying from the very first day we entered kindergarten and happened to look at the big learning centers that awaited us the next year and asked, "Where are all the walls?" Later came more complex questions, like, "How many more times do I have to pass this test before I can go out to recess again?" By sixth grade, we were asking deep philosophical questions, like, "What was that that just went by? An eraser?" As freshmen, we wondered, "Do you suppose, if we put them side by side, that we could tell the difference between today's lunch and today's biology dissection?" Finally, as juniors, the ultimate question of all came as we began doing our U.S. history battle charts. "Mr. Hart, you don't really expect us to fill in every single one of these squares, do you?" More importantly, it was the questions like, "How does a computer function? What makes my car run?" Or, "How can I build the biggest box from the least amount of cardboard?" And the questions that we received that gave us the direction in which we were to run our race. For that direction, we have all our teachers to thank. They who never turned away, always had the time to answer our questions, and they who had the integrity, if the case called for it, to say, "I don't know, but I'll find out for you." The foundations that we have built and our horizons that we have expanded are the accomplishments that we have achieved and the things that we have done. We learned something of the world beyond our area and beyond our own time zone by our grade school visits to the Indianapolis Zoo, Billy Creek Village, and the museums of Chicago. We tasted triumph our junior year as we cheered our team on to a state championship. We discovered cooperation our junior year also through a highly successful concession stand operation. And we also learned how quickly a profit can be eaten up if we don't discipline our own actions. The construction of the ballroom for our junior prom also taught us many things. Among them was the importance of each individual's talents, whether they be carpentry, artistry, engineering, motivational skills, or personnel management. But after 12 years of a steady pace in our race, we began the first day of our senior year with our second win and began to kick in for the last few yards of the race. To many, our senior year would not be all that we had hoped it would be. But to all, there was the feeling of relief, knowing that the end was near. Homecoming came upon us quickly, despite the lengthened 7-hour days. Also, with homecoming came the challenge of capturing the first place float for the third time in a year, and we all took great pride in accomplishing just that. So what if what we had originally intended to be the body section of a huge Mustang mannequin had to be transformed into a kitchen breakfast table? As first semester came to a close, most of us had chosen a path that we would follow after high school was over. Slightly under half have decided to attend a post-secondary institution of further study. Many have already found employment in the field of their vocations, and others have chosen to serve our country in the armed services. Soon May was upon us, and with it, the final big social event of the year, our senior prom. And to the delight of all, it was held at the Beef House restaurant for the first time, and it was one of the most beautiful proms ever. In retrospect, our class has achieved many feats. We have been well represented at the local, state, and national levels in vocational skills, athletic skills, leadership skills, and scholastic skills. By such endeavors, these 88 acres that are Fountain Central have been extended well beyond their borders. And then the inevitable happened. The countdowns that were in everyone's minds suddenly began appearing across the chalkboards all over the school. One day there were only 20 days left, and then it was two, and before we knew it, our senior year had come to an end, and with it, the close of our high school career. Now, in this ceremony, all of our efforts are finalized, our commitments fulfilled, and our tasks completed. But this diploma signifies only the end of the beginning phase. We have many people to thank for the excellent launching pad to the future that Fountain Central has provided us. First, our heavenly creator, who has given us this school and a free education system, our teachers, our parents, our family members, our neighbors who always bought whatever we were selling at the time, and of course, our friends. The class of 1985 would also like to extend a special thank you to three persons who are leaving with us. Mr. Bill Howard, our grade school principal, who always seemed to be a lot taller for some reason. Mr. Jack Hart, who always knew everything there was to know about anything because he was there. And to Jennifer Young, without whose help we might not have seen this day or realized our goals in the future. We wish them all Godspeed and good luck. And to my fellow classmates, I wish to share with you a quote by Oliver Wendell Holmes that was on the front of the card that was given to me by my first grade teacher. It reads, "The greatest thing in this world is not so much where we are, but in what direction we are moving. For 13 years now, we have been moving in a direction towards this day, and now it is here. Now what is important is the direction we will be moving from now on. I am confident that each and every one of you has the desire, the determination, the potential, and the abilities to succeed in whatever path you decide to run your next race. Good luck and farewell."
valedictorian for the 1985 graduating class is Carl Kletzky. Carl is the son of Mr. and Mrs. Robert Kletzky of Route 1 Wingate. Carl has been active in drama, was drama club president, is a member of the Thespian Society. Carl was also our only National Merit Scholarship finalist. We're all proud of Carl and his accomplishments. Carl?
Thank you. Fellow seniors, students, faculty, staff, administrators, family, friends. The moment that we have anticipated has arrived. For 13 years, we have looked forward to this day with a sense of both longing and dread. We are leaving to choose our own destinies, and from this point, things will no longer be the same. No matter how many times we may have said we hate school and can't wait to leave, there are things that we will all miss. We will miss being in a small school where we all know each other, where each of us is an individual and not just a face in a crowd. We will miss our friends whom we will no longer see every day. And we will have fond memories of things that we will never do again. Also, now we are expected to be adults. Some of us will go directly into the field of work. Some of us will raise families. Several of us will go on to college. In any case, we will have to work harder and have more responsibilities than ever before. We will have to make our decisions on our own without relying on the experiences of others. We will make our share of mistakes, but with every mistake, we will learn. For education is truly an ongoing process. Everything we hear, see, or think is a part of us forever. We continue to learn throughout our entire lives, for the day we cease to learn is the day we die. It is what we do with the knowledge that we have gained that is important. Everywhere in life, the true question is not what we gain, but what we do. This is the motto of the graduating class in 1985, and there is a great deal of truth to it. We are known in this world by what we leave behind. No matter how much material wealth we may have acquired, there comes a time when it will no longer be of any use to us. The only way we can be remembered fondly is through our actions, by using what we have learned to help others. In this way, we gain wealth beyond price, leaving behind a legacy of friendship. Our education continues to help us, others long after we have gone. The Fountain Central class of 1985 has reached its first goal. Now we go separately to choose our own goals. It is here that our life both ends and begins. We have come to a crossroads, and we must make our choice, knowing the only direction that we cannot go is back the way we came. For no matter how old and worn out the cliche may be, it still holds true. We may not pass this way again.
As principal of Fountain Central Junior Senior High School, it is my responsibility to ensure that the requirements of the State of Indiana, the General Commission on Education, and the Southeast Fountain School Corporation are met by those students intending to graduate. Mr. York, as superintendent, I hereby certify to you that the members of the Fountain Central High School class of 1985 have successfully fulfilled all of these requirements. At this time, I present to you, as candidates for graduation, the class of 1985.
Thank you, Mr. Williams. I'd like to recognize a few people. I'd like for those people to stand and remain standing. First of all, the Board of School Trustees, Don Luzader, Byron Rice, Peggy Perry, Ron Manning, Harry Lynn, the High School Administration, John Williams, Brian Kronk, the elementary administration, Bill Howard and Bob Baker, elementary school teachers in our audience, high school teachers in our audience, all other employees of the Southeast Fountain School Corporation, would you please stand? I'd like for the audience to look around you at these people who have provided the guidance and leadership and formal instruction which has led us to these commencement exercises today. Help me say thank you. I would now ask Mr. Williams, principal of Fountain Central Junior Senior High School, to award the diplomas.
I would invite the parents of those students, as their name is read, to receive their diploma if they would care to stand. Valedictorian of the class of 1985, presenting the diplomas at this time is the president of the Southeast Fountain School Board, Mr. Don Luzader. The valedictorian of the class of 1985, Carl Wayne Klutzke. The salutatorian of the class of 1985, Gray Lee Lawson. Kristen Michelle Luzader. Carla Jean Clements. Andy L. Zachary. Tina Marie Clausen. Brian K. Breeks. Belinda K. Spear. James W. Gossett. Lucinda Ann Shoemaker. Morris L. Crowder. Roger Kuntz. Teresa Darlene Calvin. Douglas Allen Massey. Sheila Ray Gebhardt. Barry Edward Burkhart. Deborah Lee Blankenbeckler. Samuel Scott Merriman. Laura Gail Freeman. Douglas C. Davenport. Peggy Ann LaFoe. The next group of diplomas will be presented by Mr. Byron Rice, Vice President of the Board of School Trustees. Stacy Marie Rice. Trent J. Rice. Michael D. Zeller. Jacqueline Sue Hurd. Gary G. Bussey. Timothy O. Kelly. Robert Dale Lang. Jeffrey Allen Schmidt. Melissa K. Cork. Michael L. Daniels. Forrest Cody Hesser. Kara Ellen Stockdale. Brian L. Stockdale. William V. Mortimer. Kimberly Sue Howard. Darren C. Bentley. Melissa K. Spear. Troy Damon French. Janine Marie Mitchell. Curtis L. Pig. Paula Sue Croft. The next group of diplomas will be presented by Mr. Ron Manning, member of the Southeast Fountain School Corporation. Derek M. Patton. Judy K. Hartle. Richard D. Weber. Troy D. Linker. Todd Douglas French. Edward Neil Jean. Mark Alden Fritzen. Melissa Ann Oldowney. Bradley Robert Kraut. Lisa Ann Keeling. Daniel Wayne Allen. Leah Lou Crowder. Jeffrey Max Wan. Darren Thomas Maltzberger. Sean Andrew Poole. David A. Hatch. Cynthia Leanne Keller Lewin. Michael L. Frazier. Tony Jean Dural.
Go.
Brian S. Linker. Monica Aline Williamson. The next group of diplomas will be presented by Mr. Harry Lynn, member of the Board of School Trustees. Richard Thomas, Trustee the Second. Marilyn Ann Williams. Timothy W. Allison. John Wolf. Paul L. Stettler. Roland Terrence Molinar. David M. Colbert. Elise Renee Keys. Joe E. Nine. Lisa Suzette Nixon. Timothy F. McGrady. Jacqueline Elizabeth Davis. Timothy R. Wilson. Gayla May Reed. William Dwayne Bowling. Brian E. Keller. Dawn Louise Robbins. Kristen Dawn Swenson. Scott Allen Makowitz. Scott Allen Crowder. Brian D. Cox. The next group of diplomas will be presented by Mrs. Peggy Perry, Secretary of the Southeast Fountain Board of School Trustees. Shauna Marie Hope. Eric W. Brixen. Kimberly Moore Smith. Donald Wayne Wright. Wanda Sue Oaks. Scott E. Sheridan. Sherry Lynn Blankenbeckler. Bradley Stephen Cox. Lisa Michelle Keller. Leslie A. Riley. Yvonne Marie Merriman. Paul Daniel Goins. Sarah Ann Woodrum. Harry Leo Fox. Roger Dale Pavey. Tracy Marie Brown. Todd L. Hughes. Rhonda Joe Edgar. Kevin M. Rainwater. Dina Louise Bernardi.
On this second day of June 1985, by the authority of the Indiana Department of Education, representing the Board of School Trustees of the Southeast Fountain School Corporation, as Superintendent of Schools, I now pronounce you graduates of Fountain Central Junior Senior High School.
Will you please rise? Let us pray. Dear Father in heaven, As we come to the close of this memorable occasion, we ask now that you go with us on the paths which we have chosen. Guide us in making the right decision and lift us up so that we may succeed. Be with and protect all of us that we might enjoy this time safely. Bless and keep each one of us safely here today. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.